Hello everyone, I am Robin Ménage, lead data scientist at the Boehringer Willems Clinics. And today I will share with you 5 tips for a perfect fasting day. I actually fasted for 12 days about a month ago at the Boehringer Willems Clinics, and it was a wonderful experience for me because as a scientist, I could confront my scientific knowledge to a first-hand experience of fasting. And today I will share with you some tips, but also some scientific explanation between these tips. Before the fast, prepare your body and slow down. Your body needs to be prepared for this digestive rest. So avoid excess during a week. Avoid overeating. You can also stop eating early in the evening. Stop also or reduce the addictive substances like alcohol or tobacco. Coffee is also an interesting one because coffee withdrawal can be a source of headaches. And so it's better to reduce coffee a week before the fast. And coffee can be a source of headache because the withdrawal is linked to this ability of caffeine to influence the vascular dilatation of your brain. During the fast, forget your old routine. Your body is changing during the fast. You will start burning fat, and this will cause cascade in your body, making a lot of changes. So you need to adapt to a new routine. I can take the example of sleep. In general, patients at the Boehringer Willems Clinics are sleeping less because it's understandable from the scientific point of view that digestion needs a lot of energy. So when you digest food, you need more energy. And when you are fasting, you have a lot of energy, which is provided by this fat metabolism. So overall, you will sleep less, but the quality is better. So one should not panic about that, and we should better learn to adapt to this new lifestyle. During the fast, think about doing some physical exercise. This is helping the preservation of your muscles. When you are doing some exercise, this is sending a message to your body, and what we call protein-sparing mechanisms are activated. This is helpful to preserve your mass muscle. And I can understand that it can be a bit scary at first to do a lot of exercise during fasting, but you actually have a lot of energy. And patients who attend the Boehringer Willems Clinics, sometimes they walk for 2-3 hours a day. This is what I was doing myself. And in the end, you are not so much tired. From the scientific point of view, walking during fasting will help you activating a molecular system in your muscle. This is called mTOR, and this is regulating nutrient availability. When you are fasting, mTOR in your level is overall decreasing, but in your muscle, the contraction will make it increase, and this will help you to keep your muscle. So when you fast, you will keep your muscle mass. During the fast, think about drinking a lot of water. This is very important because you might be dehydrated. When you are fasting, you have less water coming from the food. This is actually a major contributor to our water intake. And so you need to compensate by drinking more water. Drinking water will also help you eliminating toxins. When you fast, you could sometimes have some toxins which are stored in your fat, and these might be liberated during fasting. We don't know exactly what are the best detoxification strategies and plan, but one thing for sure is drinking water will help you eliminating these toxins. During the fast, another important point, which is very specific and could be a bit scary, this is the laxative. And this is a very important part of the fast. This taking a laxative to empty your bowels is part of the original Boehringer Willems method. And this is important because it will reduce the risk of having headaches and it will also reduce hunger. We know that it could reduce hunger because actually you have some taste receptors not only in your mouth but also in your gut. And this was a very surprising discovery in the last decades, that activating our taste receptors, our sugar receptors in our gut, could make us having some craving. And when you empty your gut during a fast with a laxative, this is helping making this hunger and craving feeling disappear. My next tip is, after the fast, be careful with what you eat. The food reintroduction can be as important as the fast itself, because your body will regenerate and what you will eat will influence whether this regeneration is happening well, and you have to optimize that. And we made a study about the food reintroduction at the Boehringer Wilhelmy Clinic, and we discovered that when you are reintroducing some food, your body will have an inflammatory reaction. And this is because food is like a foreign compound for your body, and so it's activating your immune system. So during fasting, your immune system is at rest, and this is one thing which explains many benefits of fasting. But when you reintroduce some food, you will reactivate your immune system, and this can cause an inflammation. So you have to be careful and not eating food which can promote this inflammation, like meat, lots of fat, alcohol, respect your circadian rhythm. In fact, inflammation, you should understand that it's also not totally negative. Inflammation is very important for our bodies. This is vital. But inflammation needs to be controlled, and the problem is when inflammation is getting out of control. So during the food reintroduction, try to respect the guidelines that you can be provided by your doctors and take it easy. You can then return to a normal and hopefully better lifestyle after 1-2 weeks, but this is a very important period that you should not neglect. Thank you for watching this video. And if you want to know more about fasting research and have more tips, please follow our YouTube channels. I wish you a good day. Bye.